Welcome student for the image enhancement part 3. In this part we are going to study the different enhancement operations using the arithmetic and logical. Start with the image enhancement using the arithmetic and logical operations. These operations are performed on the pixel by pixel basis between the two or more images, excluding the operation which is performed on the single image. So these operations, arithmetic or logical operations, are performed on the two images pixel by pixel. It depends on the hardware or the software that actual mechanism of implementation should be sequential, parallel or simultaneous. So these kind of the operations is depending upon the mostly hardware, where the hardware implementation may be the sequential, parallel or simultaneous. The logic operations are also generally operated on the pixel by pixel basis. And the only AND, OR and NOT logical operations are functionally complete, because all other operators can be implemented by using these operators. So AND, OR and NOT can be operated completely, and remaining operations can be generated or created by using these three operations also. While applying the operations on the grayscale image, the pixel values are processed as a string of binary numbers. While performing these operations on the image, whatever the grayscale image is processed or pixel value is processed in this way, that should be create the binary strings of the numbers, and then operations can be performed. The NOT operation, NOT logic operation, performs the same function as a negative transformation. So negative, we already studied the negative transformation, where the negative image can be generated. So the NOT operation can be performed like this only. So the image masking is also referred as a region of interest processing, and this is done to highlight the particular area to differentiate it from the rest of the image. Suppose if you want, if you have one image, and in that image, suppose scenery image is there, and if you want to highlight the only tree from that image, so you can use the image masking operation, where particular interest area or region can be highlighted and the rest of image can be covered by the black color. So out of the four arithmetic operations, subtraction and addition are the most useful for the image enhancement. So logical and arithmetic operations, from the different operations, so the most important operations are the subtraction and the addition for the image enhancement. So image subtraction, the enhancement of the difference between the images. G of xy is equal to f of xy, this is your original image, minus h of xy. And it is obtained by computing the difference between the all pairs of corresponding pixel from the f and h. So f is the your, so if you want to subtract the one image from the other, so that is, it takes the difference between the pair of corresponding pixel. So you will get the differences of the image. The key usefulness of the subtraction is the enhancement of the difference between the images. So enhancement parameters can be extract from the both images, or we can compare the both images by the enhancement parameter by using the image subtraction. And this concept is used in the another grayscale transformation for the enhancement, known as a bit plane slicing. The higher order bit planes of an image carry the significant amount of the visibility relevant to the details, while the lower plane contributes the fine details. So this is used, this image subtraction is used for the bit plane slicing. So we are going to check into the next slide, that is a bit plane slicing. If you subtract the four least significant bit planes from the image, the result will be nearly identical, but there is a slight drop in the overall contrast due to less visibility in the gray level values of the image. So this is the some examples of the image operations, logical or operations. Suppose this is your original image, figure A. This is the AND image mask. If you come taking the result of these two, or ending the result of these two, so you will get the third image as a result of AND operation of the image A and image B. The next one In next one, the A and B are the, these are the original image. Suppose if you perform the XORing operation, so you will get the third image, that is like this. So in this way, we are applying the different operations, that is addition and subtraction on the images. So the next one is, this is the original image. Second image is the result of setting the four lower bit planes to the zero. And the third image is the difference between these two images. And D is the histogram equalization of the this third image. Next is the mask mode radiography. The use of image subtraction is seen. This is the one of the example of the image subtraction. And the use of image subtraction is seen in the medical imaging area named as the mask mode radiography. The mask H of XY is the X-ray image of the region of patient bodies. This image is captured by using intensified TV cameras located opposite to the X-rays machine, and then consistent medium is injected into the patient bloodstreams, and then the series of the image are taken of the region same as the H of XY. And the mask is then subtracted, that is subtracted from the series of incoming images. So this subtraction will be given the area which is difference between F of XY and H of XY. And this difference will be given enhanced details of the output image. So the image difference is used for the mask mode radiography. Next one is the image averaging. Consider the noisy image, that is G of XY, formed by the addition of the noise eta of XY and the original image F of XY. That is, F of XY is the original image plus H of eta of XY is the noisy image, and eta of XY is the addition of the noise, and you will get the G of XY as a noisy image. Assuming that at every point coordinate XY, the image is uncorrelated and has zero average value, and the objective of the image averaging is to reduce the noise content by adding the set of the noise images. So the bar of, that is G bar of XY, is equal to 1 by K summation K equal to 1 to K G of XY. So taking the energy, it is the variance, standard deviation. If the image is formed by image averaging k different noisy images, as k increases, the variability of the pixel value at xy decreases. So E of G of XY is equal to F of XY. It means that G of XY approaches to the original image F of XY as the number of noisy images used in the averaging process increases. The image averaging is important in various applications, such as the field of astronomy, where the images are the low light levels. So these are the image averaging operation. So this is the histogram of the images and its corresponding images, differences images. Next is basics of spatial filtering. Spatial filtering is another example of the neighborhood operation. In these operations are done on the value of image pixel in neighborhood and the corresponding value of some sub image that has same dimension as the neighborhood. This sub images is called as a filter, mask or kernel or template or window. The value in this filter, the sub image is referred to as a coefficient rather than the pixel. So in this, we are going to refer as a coefficient rather than the pixel. The spatial filtering operations are performed directly on the pixel value of the image. This process consists of moving the filter mask from the point to point in the image. At each point XY, the response is calculated using predefined relationship. So in this processing, the process moving the filter from the point to point in the image and calculate their relationship. In linear spatial filtering, the response is given by the sum of the product of the filter coefficient and the corresponding image pixel in the area spanned by the filter mask. And the result are of the linear filtering with filter mask at point xy in the images. So these are the formulas for the masking. So this is the image size and this is the mask size. So you will get the g of x in this way, where point A is m minus 1 divided by 2 and point B is n minus 1 divided by 2. And the x varies from 0 to m minus 1 and y varies from 0 to n minus 1. These are the masking operation for the neighborhood. So this is the mask neighborhood in the original image and it can be extracted in this way. And this is the transformed pixel section, mask pixel section. So this is the formula for convolving the mask with an image, that is summation 0 to 9 w I into z I. So this is the masking operation for the coefficients of the w 0 to 1. Next is smoothing spatial filter. Smoothing means these filters are used for the blurring and noising reduction. Blurring is used in the pre-processing steps, such as the removal of the small details from an image prior to the object extraction and bridging of the small gaps in the lines or curves. The smoothing is used normally for the noise reduction, smoothing of the false contours and reduction of the irrelevant details. So for that purpose, we can use the smoothing operation. The smoothing linear filter means the output of smoothing linear filter, spatial filter, is simply the average of the pixel contained in the neighborhood of the filter mask. These filters are also called as the averaging filter or low pass filter. The operation is performed by the replacing the value of every pixel in the image by average of the gray levels in the neighborhood defined by the filter mask. And this process reduces the sharp transition in the gray levels in the image. So this is the original image smoothing operation. So it creates the blurring like this. So the major of application of the smoothing is the noise reduction, but because edges are provided using the sharp transition, so smoothing filter have undesirable side effect that they blur the edges. So due to the smoothing, so edges may be the blur. So and it also reduces the effect named the false contouring, which is caused by using the insufficient number of the gray levels in the image. The irrelevant details can also be removed by these kinds of the filter. Irrelevant means which are not of out of our interest. So that is nothing but the irrelevant data. The spatial averaging in which all coefficients are equal is sometimes referred as a box filtering or box filter. The weighted average filter is the one which pixels are multiplied by the different coefficients. So if the r is equal to 1 by summation 1 to 9 zi, so 1 by n and here 1 by 16 coefficients can be multiplied. So this is the formula for the smoothing. These are the some examples. This is the Hubble telescope. This is the image processed by 15 by 15 averaging and the result of thresholding. Next is the order statistics filter. These are the non-linear spatial filter whose response is based on the ordering of the pixel contained in the image area compressed by the filter and the replacing the value of the center pixel with the value determined by the ranking result. The best example of this is nothing but the median filter. So this filter can be studied into the next chapter also, that is image restoration. And the median filter, in this filter the value of the center pixel is replaced by the median of the gray levels in neighborhood of that pixel. And the median filter are quite popular because for the certain types of the random filters, they provide the excellent noise reduction. And these filters are particularly effective in the case of impulse or salt or paper noise. So again, this filter is again studied into the next chapter, that is the image distortion. And it is also called because of its appearance as a white and a black dot superimposed on the image. That is, a salt means white dot on the image, and paper means the black dots on the image. And again, this point will be studied into the next chapter. So we introduced some additional order statistic filter. Order statistic filter are spatial filter whose response is based on the ordering or ranking of the pixel contained in the image area encompassed by the filter. And the response of filter at any point is determined the ranking result. So this is the median filter. The details of this filter will be studied into the next chapter. Max-min filter, this is again studied in the next chapter. These are the examples. Next, sharpening of the spatial filter. The objective of the sharpening or principal objective of the sharpening is to highlight the fine details in an image or to enhance that details have been blurred either in the error or natural effects of a particular method for the image acquisition. The application of the image sharpening range from the electronic printing, medical imaging to the industrial inspection and autonomous guidance in the military system. As a smoothing can be achieved by the integration, but the sharpening can be achieved by the spatial differentiation. The integration can be achieved, but the sharpening can be achieved by the differentiation. The strength of the response of derivative operator is proportional to the degree of discontinuity of the image at that point at which the operator is applied. And thus image differentiation enhances the edges. So edges will be enhanced and other discontinuities and de-emphasizes the areas with the slow varying gray levels. And it is common practice to approximate the magnitude of the gradient by using the absolute values instead of the square or square root. The basic definition of the first order derivative of one dimensional function fx is difference. So this is the first order differentiation and second order differentiation. These are the examples for the first order and second order differentiation. The next one is the Laplacian and the Laplacian. The second order derivative is calculated by the Laplacian, and it is an isotropic filter, and the isotropic filter the one whose response is independent of the direction of the image to which the operator is applied. So this is the development method for the y direction and the x direction. These are some simplification. These are the examples of the development filter. This is the image of the north pole of the moon. Then the filtering of that image, again filtering, and the original image. These are some examples. Next, unsharp masking and high boosting filtering. Unsharp or masking means the unsharp masking means the subtracting the blurred version of the image from the image itself, where fx of xy denotes the sharpened image obtained by using the unsharp masking f of xy and is the blurred version of the f of xy. So sharpening f of xy is equal to f of xy. This is the original image and this is the unsharp image, blurred version. High boosting filter. The slight further generalization of unsharp masking is called as the high boost filtering. The high boost filtering image is defined at any point. So these are the formulas for the high boosting filtering. Thank you.